So we started this week learning how all-powerful God is. Tonight, consider how perfect our Heavenly Father is. Listen, you heavens, and I will speak. Hear, you earth, the words of my mouth. Let my teachings fall like rain and my words descend like dew, like showers on new grass, like abundant rain on tender plants. I will proclaim the name of the Lord. Oh, praise the greatness of our God. He is the rock. His works are perfect, and all his ways are just. A faithful God who does no wrong, upright and just is he. As for God, his way is perfect. The Lord's word is flawless. He shields all who take refuge in him. For who is God besides the Lord? And who is the rock except our God? Elihu said, listen to this, Job. Stop and consider God's wonders. Do you know how God controls the clouds and makes the lightning flash? Do you know how the clouds hang poised, those wonders of him who has perfect knowledge? Tell us what we should say to him. We cannot draw up our case because of our darkness. Out of the north he comes in golden splendor. God comes in awesome majesty. The Almighty is beyond our reach and exalted in power. In his justice and great righteousness he does not oppress. Therefore people revere him, for does not he have regard for all the wise in heart? The psalmist says, the law of the Lord is perfect, refreshing the soul. The statutes of the Lord are trustworthy, making wise the simple. The precepts of the Lord are right, giving joy to the heart. The commands of the Lord are radiant, giving light to the eyes. The fear of the Lord is pure, enduring forever. The decrees of the Lord are firm, and all of them are righteous. Isaiah says, Lord, you are my God. I will exalt you and praise your name, for in perfect faithfulness you have done wonderful things, things planned long ago. The last one from Matthew. Jesus said, you have heard that it was said, love your neighbor and hate your enemy. But I tell you, love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you, that you may be children of your Father in heaven. For he causes his sun to rise on the evil and the good, and sends rain on the righteous and the unrighteous. If you love those who love you, what reward will you get? Are not even the tax collectors doing that? And if you greet only your own people, what are you doing more than others? Do not even the pagans do that? Be perfect, therefore, as your heavenly Father is perfect. So it's our last time for announcements. So not too many, a few. I did get a list of junior teaching for next year. We actually got five names. If anybody feels like they missed their opportunity, come and see me. I'll add you to the list. Hopefully all of you got agenda for tonight's event. If you haven't, do we have extras? On the corner? Over here? Anybody missing some? Okay, I'll hand some out as I depart. Tonight at 8:30, you have two organized options. One is cribbage. That's over, back over at the cafeteria. Actually, three. One is cribbage, one is go over and have some snacks, and the third one is a movie tonight, The Prince of Egypt, and that is back at 101, the other hall over there. So The Prince of Egypt, if your parents let you, 8:30 is that movie going to be playing. Today we had our business meeting, and there wasn't many of us there, but a couple important things. So Lydia completed her 10 years minimum or so, and I think she was recognized before, but just recognize her again. For anyone who's worked with her, you realize how much she does and how easy she makes it look and how easy she makes it for others. So the committee will certainly miss her greatly. However, Kate Rulin is going to join the team. So next year when you check in, Lydia will be happy not to have that job, I'm sure. But Kate will. the feedback forms, just a reminder, we'd really appreciate your feedback forms. So there's three ways to do it. One is to scan the QR code in your blue book. In the back, there's a, just scan it. It's going to take you right there. The other one's on the website. Just go to the website. It's going to say feedback forms. Just click and spend 3 minutes. And what's the third one? There's a third way. Oh, we're going to send you an email in a couple days, and it's going to remind you in case you forgot. So we'd especially like the young people. Like, we really need more young people at this Bible school. If young people can tell us what maybe we're doing wrong, what we need to do right, or what we could do to draw your, more of your peers, we would appreciate your feedback. There will be final treats tonight. And at the end of our evening, we will do Days of Elijah, so we'll give you a couple minutes if you're a little unsure about that or a little, you know, that's not for you. But if you're up for it, you'll enjoy it, I'm pretty sure. So that'll be the very end tonight. As far as final cleanup for your rooms, I've said it a couple times, but basically, if you have sheets from the school, wrap them up, put them outside in a pile. If you have blankets, fold them nicely, put them in the same pile. For your keys, put them downstairs in each dorm. There's a little office there. Put them right up on that little ledge there. Garbage goes outside. I think that's about all. Is there any other announcements? Pardon? Oh, leave your doors to your room open, please. Yeah. All right, that sounds great. Let's start with our opening hymn, which is 365. Is that not right? Oh, I thought someone groaned. What? We'll have hymn 365 and then an opening prayer.
Made precious gold out of this week for us, and although it's the end of the week, it's not the end of our lives. Let our praise tonight rise to you as a sweet smelling aroma, and as we go home and to our various locations, let us keep in mind this this joyous time of fellowship and praise and meals and lessons we've learned from both young and old, that we might be better and walk as better servants of you, reaping and harvesting the faith that we see growing around in those around us and in ourselves. Please heal those who are sick. Please be with your people in Israel and bind the fellowships in unity. Please bless this night and always bless us in Christ's name. Please bring him soon. Amen.
Great Lakes Christadelphian Bible School Youth Chorus presents Sing a Story, Share God's Glory.
Thank you.
To warm up, we're going to sing a song that illustrates how Noah and Moses walked with God. Speaking of Moses, our first story is a song about Moses as a baby and how God watched over him. He watches over us too. That's pretty marvelous.
Moses in the river Nile long.
Our next story is about the 10 plagues of Egypt. We also like the audience to join in on this response part to the song. You can find this on page 1 of your program.
God sent 10 plagues.
God sent 10 plagues.
Long, long ago.
Long, long ago.
To change the mind of the Pharaoh.
The Pharaoh.
He turned the water into blood. But did the Pharaoh let God's people go from Egypt land?
Oh, no.
God sent 10 plagues.
God sent 10 plagues.
Long, long ago.
Long, long ago.
To change the mind of the Pharaoh.
The Pharaoh.
He sent them frogs.
Frogs.
He turned the water into blood. But did the Pharaoh let God's people go from Egypt land?
Oh, no.
God sent 10 plagues.
God sent 10 plagues.
Long, long ago. Mind of the Pharaoh,
the Pharaoh.
He sent them lice.
Wow.
He sent them frogs.
Wow.
He turned the water into blood. But did the Pharaoh let God's people go from Egypt land?
Oh, no!
God sent 10 plagues.
God sent 10 plagues.
Long, long ago.
Long, long ago.
To change the mind of the Pharaoh.
The Pharaoh.
He sent them flies.
Flies.
He sent them lice.
Lice.
He sent them frogs.
Frogs.
He turned the water into blood. But did the Pharaoh let God's people go from Egypt land?
Oh, no.
God sent 10 plagues.
God sent 10 plagues.
Long, long ago.
Long, long ago.
To change the mind of the Pharaoh.
The Pharaoh.
He sent them flies.
Flies.
He sent them mice.
Mice.
He sent them frogs.
Frogs.
He turned the water into blood. But did the Pharaoh let God's people go from Egypt land?
Oh, no!
God sent 10 plagues.
God sent 10 plagues.
Long, long ago.
Long, long ago.
To change the mind of the Pharaoh.
The Pharaoh.
He sent them flies.
Flies.
He sent them mice.
Mice.
He sent them frogs.
Frogs.
He turned the water into blood. But did the Pharaoh let God's people go from Egypt land?
Oh, no.
God sent 10 plagues.
God sent 10 plagues.
Long, long ago.
Long, long ago.
To change the mind of the Pharaoh.
The Pharaoh.
He sent them hail.
Hail.
He sent them boils.
Boils.
The cattle died.
Died.
He sent them flies.
Flies.
He sent them mice.
Flies.
He sent them frogs.
Frogs.
He turned the water into blood. But did the Pharaoh let those people go from Egypt land?
Oh, no.
God sent 10 plagues.
God sent 10 plagues.
Long, long ago.
Long, long ago.
To change the mind of the Pharaoh.
The Pharaoh.
He sent them locusts.
Locusts.
He sent them hail.
Hail.
He sent them boils.
Boils.
The cattle died.
Flies.
He sent them flies.
Flies.
He sent them mice.
Mice.
He sent them frogs.
Frogs.
He turned the water into blood. But did the Pharaoh let those people go from Egypt land?
Oh, no.
God sent 10 plagues.
God sent 10 plagues.
Long, long ago.
Long, long ago.
To change the mind of the Pharaoh.
The Pharaoh.
He sent them locusts.
Locusts.
He sent them hail.
Hail.
He sent them boils.
Boils.
The cattle died.
Died.
He sent them flies.
Flies.
He sent them mice.
Mice.
He sent them frogs.
Frogs.
He turned the water into blood. But did the Pharaoh let God's people go from Egypt land?
Oh, no.
The lesson from the story of the 10 plagues teaches us that it's important to follow and obey God. This next song helps us to remember to do that. Our third story is about Jesus feeding a whole lot of people at one time. That comes from Matthew 14.
Tiny loaves the people all sat down. He blessed the food and broke the loaves and passed it all around. When everyone was full and could not eat another bite, they filled 12 baskets with the scraps. It was some fantastic sight.
The feeding of the multitude teaches us about God's glory that shines through Jesus. When we share these stories with others, we share God's glory. Please join us in singing "Sing a Story, Share God's Glory" on page 2. Our fourth story is about Jesus walking on water. How amazing is that? It also comes from Matthew 14. We learn that Jesus will hold his hand out to us when we struggle and lift us up out of troubled waters. That's why our story people should know about.
Sailed far along, the waves beat against it, though soak. As to him he drew near. Take heart, it is I. Then he said, have no fear. Peter answered him, Lord, if it's really you, bid me on the water to come unto you.
Come, said Jesus, and so Peter went out walking on the sea, walking on the sea, walking on the sea. Now when Peter saw the wind, he stopped walking on the sea. Oh no! He cried, Lord, please save me.
Right when Jesus called, Peter his hand reached out. O man of little faith, he said, why did you doubt? And when they got into the boat, the wind ceased, while those who were there found their faith had increased.
So they worshipped.
On our fifth story is from Matthew 22, where it says that the kingdom of God may be compared to a king who gave a marriage feast for his son. It teaches us to be ready for God's glorious kingdom when he comes back to the earth. We invite the audience to use the song sheet and sing along with the chorus on page 5.
Table and wore a wedding gown. He sent an invitation to his neighbors far and wide. But when the meal was ready, each of them replied,
I cannot come, I cannot come, I cannot come to the banquet. Don't trouble me now. I have married a wife, I have bought me a cow, I have fields and commitments that cost a pretty sum. They will be.
All right, are we ready?
Rose up in anger, called his servants by name, said, go into the town, fetch the blind in the lame, fetch the peasant in the pauper, for this I have willed. My banquet must be crowded, and my table must be filled. I cannot come,
I cannot come,
I cannot come to you.
I have
fields and
business that cost a
go search everywhere, to the highways and the byways, and force them to come in. My table must be filled before the banquet can begin.
I cannot come.
If we're slow in responding, he may leave us behind. He's preparing a banquet for that great and glorious day. When the Lord and Master calls us, be certain that we say,
yes, I can come.
Yes, I can come.
Yes, I can come, yes, I can come to the banquet.
We need to patiently wait and share God's stories until he sets up his kingdom. Ecclesiastes 3 says he will make all things beautiful in his time.
He makes all things beautiful.
This evening's program, The Greatest of These is Love. Seek things from above and put on the new man, put on love.
Thank you. Oh,
Please feel free to sing along if you know this one.
It should be on your phones. Nicholas said there's a go to the website or something. I don't know how to do that, but if anybody wants to sing along or knows it, you're welcome to sing along.
Just go to gltbf.org. It's right there, the front page.
Verse 2.
Thank you. stay up here and call them for me.
We'll close with number 61, and then Tom will give us a closing prayer. Everybody will stay. So I think we really appreciate everyone for everything they did, for all the choirs, for Julie and Cassie. I could tell they did a ton of work, and their helpers, so thank you very much. So number 61, is that on the website too now? Or do we know 61? Pardon? Okay, thank you. That one we know. If you can stay somewhere close. So following the hymn and closing prayer, you have a couple minutes if you want to leave. If somebody wants to set up some food, there's some things to grab over there, and then we'll have Days of Elijah.
Thank you so much for the time this week that we've had together. We do pray for the peace of Jerusalem. We earnestly long for it, Father, and we hope that it will be very soon. And as we go away from this place to go out into the world to do our regular activities. Help us to be mindful of the things that we've enjoyed this week, the instruction, the edification, the fellowship, the camaraderie that we've had with each other. You are indeed a blessed and a merciful Father, and we depend so much on you. We are so mindful of every blessing which you give us. Everything that we have is yours, Father, and we bow before you and in humility, recognizing that you brought your Son into this world, your only begotten Son. You offered him up for us, and we were not worthy. So, Father, be with all of us here. Be with those who are weak, those who are failing, those who doubt their faith, those who are searching for faith. Strengthen all of us, Father, and bless us. For we ask this through the name of our great King, even Jesus Christ. Amen.